slope, remember that the slope is always the change in y over the change in x. So if you look at these 2 points, how much does y change? Between this point and that point, how much does y change?
Zero.
It doesn't change at all. We could do the difference in the two y values and find 2 minus 3 is 0. How much does the x change?
1, 2, 0, 2. Wait, it's negative. 4. 4. 4.
1, 2, 3, 4. Or we could say 3 minus -1. 3 minus 3 is 0. 3 minus -1, that's 3 plus 1. That's 4. What's 0 divided by 4?
0. 0.
So if you divide 0 by anything, you get 0. Let's just have a quick little quiz here. If my line looks like this, what kind of slope is that? Yeah, positive slope. We see an increase. Okay. If this were like the graph of the height of water over time, then this time we see a small amount of water, and then later on, as we move forward in time, we see more water. So we see an increase, we see a positive change. As we look at the change in x is positive. The change in y is positive. So we get positive over positive. That's a positive slope. And what kind of slope do we have here?
Negative.
This is the graph of your money over time. Okay, so at the beginning you have some money. Later on you have less money. Right. So we see a positive change in x. The change in x is in the denominator. And for y you see a negative change in y. What's negative divided by positive? Let me point this out. If I were to start here and go backwards, what kind of change in x would that be?
Negative.
It would be a negative change in x. But then I would go down. And what kind of change in y is that?
Negative.
That's a negative. So we have a negative change over a negative change. What's negative divided by a negative?
Positive.
It's still a positive. So.
Whoa.
And this one, if I were to go back, what kind of change in x would that be?
Negative.
A negative change in x. But then I would go up to get to this point. Positive. What's positive divided by negative?
Positive. Negative.
So we have a negative slope. So if you see a slope like this, positive slope like this, negative slope. So if we were to go back, thinking about these points we were just giving, and just like, even really quickly in your head, just think about where these points are, you can get a good idea of what kind of slope you have. So negative 3, 1 is like there-ish. Negative 1, 5 is somewhere up here. Right? So what kind of slope should we expect? What's that? A positive slope. Right? As time goes on, we see an increase. We see a positive rate. To figure out how much the change in x is, find the difference in the two x's. Let's say negative 3 minus negative 1. It doesn't matter which I can do negative 1 minus negative 3. It won't make any difference. Because if I choose negative 3 minus negative 1, since negative 3 came first, then the y value from that point also needs to come first. So it'll be 1 minus 5. We get negative 4. 1 minus 5 is negative 4 over negative 3 plus 1 is negative 2. Negative 4 divided by negative 2 is positive 2. If we did it the other way around, if we did negative 1 minus negative 3, well, negative 1 minus negative 3, I'd have to go 5 minus 1. 5 minus 1 is positive 4. 1 minus negative 3, or sorry, negative 1 plus 3 is going to be 2. And we have positive 4. We're positive 2, which is still 2. So either way you go, as long as you keep the order the same, like these two guys here come from the same point, these come from the other point. These guys came from the same point, these guys come from the other point. As long as that happens, it's all gonna work out the same. It's all good. It's all gonna be exactly the same slope. Okay. So, does that answer that question? 16 makes sense?
Yes.
Finding the slope. Okay. Now if the slope is the same as what? When we started looking at those glasses and finding how fast it was filling up, right? And then we looked at the graph.
Oh yeah.
And we saw the slope there. The slope, Hunter, and what are the same?
The change of rate.
Yeah, rate of change. The slope and the rate of change are the same. What that means is, okay, this slope is saying, right, 2, it's 2 over 1. So it's saying every time you move over 1, you move up 2. Every time you move over 1, you move up 2, and so on and so on and so on. Okay. Well, if x represented minutes and y represented dollars, so the x-axis is minutes and the y-axis is dollars, okay, then this rate would be, or the x would be minutes, the y would be dollars, and our slope would represent dollars per minute. So this would be $2 per minute. So the rate and the slope, they're the same thing. Just depending on what x and y represent, that rate is going to be different for different problems. That was 16, now on to 20. So we've got ramp, that's 6 feet up and 8 feet horizontal, and the hill, that is 12 feet horizontal, 8 feet vertical. Okay, we can use the slopes to compare how steep each of these is. Okay. So it might even help to just redraw this so it's kind of going in the same direction here, 6 feet. Now these slopes are so close to each other, it's difficult to tell just by looking at them. Okay. So let's look at the slopes. What's the slope of this ramp? The slope is the change in y, which is vertical, over the change in x, which is horizontal. What's the slope of this ramp? What's the vertical change from the bottom to the top? How much have you changed vertical? Take a look at the board. You keep looking at me and shrugging your shoulders, it's not really going to help. Hunter?
6 over 8.
Vertical?
It goes 6 up and then 8, right?
Yeah, it goes 6 up, right? So 6 is the vertical, and the horizontal is 8. It goes up 6 and over 8. We could try and simplify this. 3 over 4. Let's look at this guy. What's the vertical change on this one? What's just the vertical change? Change vertically, Cole?
8, 12.
What's the vertical change? Just the change vertically. What is it?
8.
Just vertical is 8. What's the horizontal change?
12.
Let's simplify these. I guess divide both by 4, so 2/3. Okay. It's still hard to compare these two, okay? So we're going 2 up and 4 right. We're going 2 up and 3 right. Okay. Which one's deeper? We need some kind of comparison. Like something needs to be the same. I need to know, like, for this many feet over, I go this many feet up. Right?
Make a common denominator.
Common denominator, very good. So the denominator is going to be what?
12.
So this is going to be how many twelfths?
Nine
twelfths. And this is gonna be
eight twelfths.
So let's think about the significance of this slope. It means that for every 12 feet that I go right, every 12 feet that I go right, what happens?
It goes
9 feet up. For every 12 feet that I go right here, what happens? You go 8 feet up. So which is harder to walk up?
So that's a ramp.
So you go up the ramp because you're just going the same horizontally, but for those 12 feet you go horizontally, you have to go up 9 feet as opposed to 8 feet, right? Which wouldn't be as difficult. So since for the same amount of horizontal, we have to do more vertically, could you just take that? That was it. So that was 11, 16, 20. Okay. Remember vertical change or horizontal change, the difference in two y values over the difference in two x values. And remember to take them in the same order, because let's say we had something like 2, 4. Let's make it even easier than that. 2, 8, and 5. A lot of times what I see students doing, Jayden, a lot of times what I see students doing is they'll take this y minus this y over this x, wanting to get two positive values, and they get 5 over 3. But if we look at the graph, see if you can tell me why that can't be. Right, 2, 8, 5, 3, let's just say that's a real rough sketch. Why can't this be correct? Look at this line. So the graph tells me I should have what kind of a slope?
Positive.
Isn't this positive?
Well, so the graph is going up.
Since you started with the 8 first, you have to start with the 2 first from the bottom. So
okay.
It would be 2 minus 5.
So it should have been 2 minus 5. But when I'm looking at the line, the question I'm asking here is what kind of slope does the line tell me?
Negative positive.
Who's the one who answered this last?
I did.
This kind of a line has what kind of a slope?
A negative.
A negative. As x, right, has a positive increase. The change in x is positive because we're moving to the right. To get to this point, what kind of change in y are we going to have?
Negative.
You have to go down. So the change in y is going to be have to be negative.
The change in y is negative.
So we get a negative vertical change, a negative change in y over a positive change in x. We should get a negative slope. And the way we can fix that is, as Hunter said, if we do 8 minus 3, we need to come back and do 2 first, minus 5, and that'll give us 5 over negative 3, or negative 5 thirds. So whatever order you start, if you start with the 2 here, 2 minus 5 for the denominator, you need to do 8 minus 3 for the numerator. If you do 5 minus 2 for the denominator, you need to do 3 minus 8 for the numerator. So find the slope between two points here.
Yeah.
Let's put everything away instead of some piece of paper.
Oh.
What do you mean by a positive rate means it goes up?
It doesn't decrease, it increases.
So
yeah.
As time goes that way, right?
Yeah.
As time moves forward,
yeah,
we see an increase. Okay. Time is a common and convenient example to use. It's not always time, of course, it can be something else, but time is a really convenient, common thing to use for x. As time goes on, whatever increases, okay? And what does it mean to have a negative rate of change?
Goes down.
Time goes up forward, then whatever goes down, the height of the water goes down, your money decreases, your weight represents that graphically as a graph, right, as a picture of what's going on. If we see a positive slope, we have a positive rate of increase. We have a positive slope, we see increase, right, as time goes on. It goes up, the line goes up. If we see a decrease, then the line goes down because as time goes on, the amount goes down, we see a decrease. Okay? So if I were to really quickly graph 1, 4, just this is kind of even a picture of what's going on in my head, just really briefly looking at these points, imagining these points, 1, 2, 3, 4, more down here, -3. Okay, what kind of slope should I expect to find?
Negative
slope. As we move this way, we move down, as time moves forward, the amount decreases. Right, I can think of this as like a 1 minute. At 1 minute I have $4. At 5 minutes, I have -$3. Okay. Whatever I choose to just throw in there for X and Y to represent, it can almost be nonsense. But if I put a time on this and an amount of something, of dollars, of miles, of inches, of pounds, of people, of whatever, okay, that's often going to help me understand what the slope means. The slope represents a rate of change. So if I were to think of this as minutes, and this as dollars, and I wanted to figure out how many dollars per minute we're talking about here, how much do the dollars change from this time to this time?
Two.
Dollars change
negative.
Two?
Negative. So it could be.
Well, here I have $4, then I have -$3. How many dollars did it change?
Four.
Start at four, drop all the way down to -3. Jasper?
-7.
Yeah, it goes down 7, right? It goes down to 0, right? I lose $4, then I lose $3 more. I go into the negatives. I owe $3.
Seven.
So -$7. So I see a drop in $7. How long did that take? 2 seconds?
Six.
We started out at 1 minute, ending at 5 minutes. How many minutes did that take?
5 minutes.
If 1 minute's already gone by, then I hit my stopwatch, I start timing it, starting at 1 minute, and I go all the way to 5 minutes and stop the stopwatch.
Four.
How many minutes have gone by?
Four. 4 minutes. Right?
Start at 1, end at 5. 4 minutes have passed. So that's a rate that we just kind of made up.
There is a silver Impala.
You were driving a silver Impala.
Green.
So our slope of the line is -7/4. If we were to just do the subtraction, figure out what's the difference in y and the difference in x, we could have done -3 minus 4 over -3 minus 4, that's 5 minus 1 in the denominator. -3 minus 4 is -7. That's the $7 that I lost. Right. 5 minus 1, that's 4. That's the 4 minutes that passed. If I got it backwards, it would look kind of funny, but it would be 4 minus -3 and 1 minus 5. And what's 4 plus 3? 4 plus 3 is 7. What's 1 minus 5,
Colby? 4.
Quite?
-4.
-4. Okay. So this is a little bit strange if I make my x and y represent these things, minutes and dollars. I get $7. My dollars increase 7 by 7, right? $7 increase. But what happens in the time? How much time has passed? How many?
-4 minutes.
How do -4 minutes go by? What's that? You have to go backwards in time, right? Backwards in time. Which, you know, time travel, or maybe if you're watching a video, you rewind the video 4 minutes, right? If you were to start at the end and rewind back to the beginning, or back 4 minutes, you would see the amount go up, right? If I go backwards 4 minutes, I see that we go up 7. But if I go forward 4 minutes, then we're gonna lose 7, whatever, dollars in this case.
Okay.
Let's find the slope of this line. Let's just think about it for a second. Negative 2, 3 is somewhere right there. Right, 6, 12. It's up there somewhere, right? We know it's way up there. What kind of a slope should I expect?
Positive.
A positive slope. Expect to get a positive slope. It's a good check for if we did our work correctly. From this point to, I guess this point, to this point, how much does x change? How much does x change from here to there? The x is right there. There's an x. There's an x. How much does x change from this point to that point?
4.
Eight.
Yeah, we have to go 2 to get to 0, then 6 more, right? We can see that if we do 6 minus negative 2, that's 6 plus 2, our change, our horizontal change is 8. And how much does it change vertically as we move up? How much is our vertical change? From here to there. Starts out at negative 2, 3. Start out at 3. And we go up to this point, which is at 6, 12. 12. We go up. How much do we have to go up to go from 3 to 12?
9.
We go up 9. 12 minus 3 is 9. Up 9 over 8 over 8, up 9, positive slope. If we were to have switched these around and then 3 minus 12 and negative 2 minus 6, what's 3 minus 12?
Negative
9.
9,
10. Negative 2 minus 6?
4.
Negative 2 minus 6. Remember, we're at negative already, minus 6 more. We're more to the left. We're at negative 8. But that's a negative 9 divided by negative 8. A negative divided by negative is positive, so we have a positive 9. So either way, we get positive 9 or positive 8. Is a little bit of a challenge here. Okay, we've already done the first part several times, right? How much or how quickly is the glass filling with water? I want you to figure that out first. Then I want you to figure out how much was in the water at 0, or how much water was in the glass. How high was the water at 0 seconds? Do something you've already done several times. Figure out how fast the glass is filling with water. Use that information to figure out how much water is in the glass to start with. If you don't know about this, forget about it for a second. Just figure out how quickly it's filling with water. Start there and see if you can help me answer this question. Start here. Start here. Then move on. Is it filling with water? Okay.
2 seconds of filling. 4 centimeters.
So 4 centimeters for every 2 seconds. Which simplifies to what? Okay.
2 centimeters in 1 second.
2 centimeters every 1 second. 2 centimeters per second. Phrase that way, per second. 2 centimeters per second. Now, we've done that lots of times. How do I use that information to figure out how much water there was in the beginning?
Well, I did like, I saw that 2 centimeters. Or 1 second, so you can't really go one more below 1 and 0. I just got one from each side.
One from what?
Both sides got 1 centimeter.
Both sides of what?
For 0 seconds. One.
So you took this fraction 2 over 1, you subtracted 1 from here and subtracted 1 from here. letting you out of here, and the more you talk, the more time it's going to take, so let's stop the murmuring and the packing, and let's just pay attention. Adam used the information that it's going 2 centimeters every second. How can we use this information and that information together to figure out how many centimeters there were to start with? Cody?
Never mind.
Hunter?
So, since it goes 1 second, every 1 second goes 2 centimeters, you're minus 5 seconds from 5 to 12 gets 0, and then you times 5 by 2, so that would be 10, and then you minus 2 from 12, so it would be 2 centimeters.
So, if we go back 5 seconds, 1, 2, 3, 4, that's not quite. If we go back 5 seconds, 1 second, 2 seconds, 3 seconds, 4 seconds, 5 seconds, well, then we should see the water where it started, right?
Yeah.
Well, we can go backwards in time, right? We can go down 2 centimeters for every second, 2 centimeters, 2 centimeters, 2 centimeters, 2 centimeters, 2 centimeters. How many centimeters is that?
10.
2 times 5, just like Hunter said. We take that away from the 12, right?
Yep.
We know it was going at 5 seconds. 5 seconds ago, at 0 seconds, we should see 2 centimeters. This is your homework. This problem right here is your homework. Okay. Did you have it written down? Have a good day.